Welcome back to another Keep Moving with Emily. Today's workout is an endurance workout, so grab something to write with and your weights and get ready for a full body endurance workout. You ready? Let's keep moving. All right, so like I said, grab something to write with, grab your weights. I have a box. I'm gonna be doing dips in one of the exercises, but if that doesn't work for you, you can do overhead tricep extensions. I've got a mat, I've got some weights. Welcome to Keep Moving with Emily. So glad that you're joining me. We're gonna get a nice little dynamic warm up in. We're gonna jump right into cardio and then move into the rest of the workout with some strength endurance workout using a really fun format that I'll tell you a little bit more about. So if you're ready, we're gonna get nice and warmed up. So change my song. All right, let's do a nice little sidestep and open up those arms. If you've been sitting all day, you need to get moving. Open up those arms nice and big. Side step, get that blood pumping. The point of, warm ups, we gotta get those muscles warm, get the blood pumping before we move in to the real deal. Let's pull those arms back, get a nice little hamstring curl here. Good. Good. We're gonna get moving, shaking. The full body workout today, it's gonna feel good. Glad you are joining me today. Nice. Let's pull arms, come up and down right here. Nice. Reach and pull. Working the core, working the balance. Turning on the brain as we work that single-sided balance. Good, reach and pull. Three, two, and one. Let's reach it up and over. And I say this every time. My warm-ups feel the same. It may feel a little dull. We gotta get all these muscles warmed up. Super important. It's okay if it looks the same. Kinda know what to do. Get a nice little twist and reach. Reach. Work that core. Nice little twist in the spine. Squeezing those glutes. Good. Good. Give me three. Two. And a one. Nice, let's get some nice little knee hugs. Hug and ankle roll. Working that balance. Getting a nice stretch in that hip flexor, a little bit in the glute, lower back. Let's do one more. Woo! On each side. Good, we'll kind of get some nice little hamstring scoops where you reach and circle. Good, nice big circles with those arms. Reach for those toes. Nice. Woo. Very good. This time we're gonna reach it back. Reach those arms up, get a nice stretch in that hip flexor. Arms come down and switch. We're stepping back, leg stays straight. Reach it up, feeling a nice stretch right here. And switch. We're gonna be doing some lunges today, some squats today. All the fun stuff. All those major muscle groups. Last one. Woo. Good. All right, if you need to do some like toy soldiers, maybe we're gonna kick it out to the side. Do a nice little twist. Warming up those glutes a little bit. Good, nice little hamstring stretch. Little core movement. Three. Two. One more on each side. Nice. All right. March it out. I'm going to throw it up on the screen. We're going to be doing a cardio blast. So you're going to want to follow along with me. You're going to be great. Put it up on the screen so you know what we're doing. But get ready for a nice little cardio blast. So, cardio up on the screen. That's what we're doing. When that music starts, we're going to start off with a nice little jog, and then we're going to go through these moves as I kind of lead us into. Here we go. And Angus has decided to join us. All right, so you can either do a nice little sidestep. You do a little boxer shuffle here. Good. I'm going to show some low-impact options. I'm going to show you those high-impact options. Maybe you're just marching in place, or you're jogging. Let's go. You can do a nice little butt kick if you want. Good. Music's gonna speed up and so will we. Speed up, let's go. Up. Fast feet, fast feet. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Jumping jacks. Here we go. High impact here. Yep. Or low impact, you just tap that foot out. Good. Keep it up, keep it up. Moving into those squat jumps or squat with a calf raise. So jump it out. You can either be here or you can go narrow to wide squats. Up to you. Good, explode. Land soft on those knees. 3, 2, and 1. Jump rope, here we go. So you can either do a little boxer shuffle or you're here with that jump rope. You're ready because we're about to do burpees. You can do hardcore burpees. You can also go to an elevated surface. Here we go. Bring it down, kick those feet out, and up, or you're here, elevated surface, walk it up. Good. Last one. Jog it out, let's go. So we're doing a cardio blast. Woo! All right. Feet, feet, let's go, fast. Speed it up, speed it up, speed it up. Jack, let's go, up. Good. Gotta get that heart rate up there. 2 minutes of street cardio. Again, modified. You're here. 3, 2, squat jumps, or you're just here. Nice little squat tap here, or you're in that high impact version. Yep. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Holy heart rate, it is up there. Awesome job. Grab some water. I'm putting the workout up on the screen so you know what we're about to do. Grab that pen. Awesome job. Hopefully you can see what's up on the screen. I want you to grab those weights. And I want you to grab your pin. I'm gonna put on time. You're gonna count your reps. And when we're done, I want you to write down your reps, all right? So, I'm gonna put up a timer real quick. We're gonna be working for about 30 seconds here. I'm gonna go through these. Here we go. So, first move is a nice little weighted squat. Hold one weight, two weights. Down to your side or up at your chest. Nice little squat, squeeze through those glutes. You can always do a sit to stand with a chair. And then we'll move on. So I'm probably gonna use one weight because we'll be using one weight for the next move. So it's up to you. We're gonna get started in 10 seconds. I want you to count these reps. In 5, 4, I want you to do quality, but kind of quick. Here we go. It up from the side, booty comes back, chest stays up, squeeze. Time, write that number down. This is the problem when I talk and try to count. Write that number down for exercise number one. We want to make sure we hit that number. Hopefully that's right. Okay. Exercise number two, grab one weight. We're doing a single arm lunge with a press. So, weight's in your right hand. You're gonna step forward into a forward lunge with that left leg. Weight comes underneath. Step and press. Or we can come reverse. Yeah, do a reverse lunge. Leg comes back. Under and press. Count each one. You ready? 6 seconds, we'll get started. So reverse lunge, left foot's gonna come, we'll figure it out. Okay, down, press. Keep it up. Good. Keep breathing. Nice. Write that number down. That one makes your brain work. Stepping back, pressing under. Good. All right. 10 seconds, we'll move on to the next move. Lateral leg raise with a front raise. So only grab one weight again. Think about how much weight you can lift forward because we're gonna go out to the side with a front leg, front raise with that leg. You try 8 pounds. See where you're at? You got this, 10 seconds. We're gonna get started. Woo! Again, I have a slight bend in my elbows. Weight's gonna come up to my eyes. Each time I lift, alternate what leg raises up. Let's go count. Keep it up. Woo! Tops of those shoulders and booty. Good work. Again, write down that number for exercise number 3. You're gonna use these later, so don't forget. Exercise number 4, we're gonna be either doing dips or overhead extension. So, overhead extension, weight's gonna come here. Tuck those elbows in. You're gonna extend up, or you're doing a good old little dip. You can join me on this step if you want. Again, we're not doing a hip thruster. Booty comes down to the floor and all the movement is in those arms. Bend at the elbows and extend. Work in the back of the arm. Triceps, 5 seconds, let's go. You ready? Work those triceps. Exhale as you press up, inhale as you come down. Rest. Write that number down. You're doing great. Exercise number 5, wall sit with a curl. You're counting how many curls. I want your, when you're on that wall, I want those knees to be bent at 90 degrees. Working a little bit of a static hold with a curl. Let's go, 10 seconds, we're gonna get started. Hop on that wall or you can do a squat hold if you really want. 4, 3, 2, let's go, curl. Exhale as you curl it up. But I do a lot. I'ma make a toast. Cause we're still alive. No big. I feel like pot. Shoot the shot. I'm coming in. Woo! Nice job. Write that number down. You got this. Catching our breath. Here we go. All right. Rows. Figure out which weights you want. I want you to have both feet kind of shoulder width apart, slipping in the knees. Hinging at the waist. Weights come down. And we're pulling those weights up, squeezing the shoulder blades, keeping those arms nice and tight. We're working our back. So. Nice little rows. You ready? Let's go. 10 seconds. Working that endurance. Shoulder width apart. Slide bend in the knees. Roll those shoulders down the back. Hinge. And pull it up. Let's go. You got it. Keep it up. Woo! You got it. A little bit more leg stabilization and working the back as you pull those elbows back, squeezing the back. Write that number down. Last movement, we're doing a chest press. If you can, I want you to hold a bridge, all right? Hips are up to the sky, elbows are gonna come down, and we're gonna press it up. If you really wanna challenge yourself, do push-ups. I'm gonna do chest press. Here we go. You got this. Don't worry, I'm gonna give it time to rest. Recover. And then we're gonna use these numbers. So, again, you're gonna go flat on your back. Feet can either be flat on the floor, elbows are out wide, and we're pressing the weight up. If you want more of a challenge, do it in the hip bridge. If you want a more challenge, just push. Last set, here we go. Keep those hips up. Elbows are wide. Exhale, press it up, and inhale down. Write that number down, catch your breath, grab some water, and I'm gonna explain what we're about to do with these numbers. All right, I don't know about you, I'm gonna let you know what numbers I'm doing. Here's the nice thing about these workouts. It is you versus you. Whatever your number is, that is what you're focusing on, not what I'm doing, okay? We all have different levels of ability. We're all having different days. Some days we feel stronger, some days we feel a little weak, so these are your numbers, so ignore mine, but mine average from like 18 to 21. So, guys, what am I doing with these numbers? Well, here's what's gonna happen. We are doing, drum roll please, an EMOM. Every minute on the minute, okay. So you're like, Emily, what does that mean? Every minute on the minute. Those numbers you just wrote down, once you hit that number, whatever exercise we're on, you have a minute to complete that number. Once you finish, you get to rest until the next timer, the little dingy bell, and then you start to the next one. So, for example, weighted squat, I gotta get 18. Once I hit 18, whatever that number is for you, I get to rest until the next minute. And once that next minute hits, that's when I do exercise number two. You hit your rep number, and you rest until the next one. So we're about to do 7 minutes of exercise. You're gonna hit that number, the quicker you get done with your rest, the more rest you have. So gauge your endurance level, pace yourself, don't get crazy on the first one because you know that you out in 7 more minutes of exercise, okay? Super fun, I know. I'm here with you, I'm gonna feel the burn as well. So we're gonna be working for 1 minute, quick transition, you're gonna hear that whistle, and then we move on to the next one, okay? I think we're ready. So find that number. Figure out what number you're doing. Count. Let's do this. We are strong today. Hey. All right. Find your weight. Let's do this. I'm doing one weight. Hitting my number. You ready? Squat. Let's go. Meet your number. You rest. Nice, once you hit that number, you get to rest. So, keep working, essentially. When we did this, we did about 30 seconds. So, it should take you about 30 seconds. Then you have 30 seconds or so to recover. You got 15 more seconds to finish that number. We're moving on to that single arm lunge press. Get ready. Gotta remember what I'm doing. All right, hit that next number, whatever it is. Lunges. 1 minute, let's go. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 60 seconds. You're lunging and pressing. Bring that weight underneath and press. Good. Try to keep that chest up. Good. Legs, shoulders. Good, keep working. 20 seconds. Good job, good job. 20 seconds to finish that rep count, whatever it is that you wrote down. 10 seconds, we're moving in. Exercise number 3, that lateral leg raise with the front raise. You ready? Exercise number 3. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. That is that way comes up. Squeeze that glute. Nice job. Keep working. Core is tight. Nice. Ooh, once you hit that number, rest. About 20 seconds. Then we're moving into those dips or overhead tricep extension. Get ready. Hit that number. You get to rest. Remember, the quicker you get done with those reps, the more rest you have. Here we go. We're about to get those dips. I can get 21. I don't know how many you need to get. We're going to start in 3, 2, 1. Either dips or over tricep extensions. Working the back of the arm. Rest, if you were there, hit that number, shake out those arms. Ooh. Sometimes that time makes us go faster so we have more time to rest, but our muscles are getting tired. They're getting fatigued, keep pushing. Less than 20 seconds to finish your rep count, and then we're moving on to that wall sit with a curl. Let's go, once you're ready, get ready. We're gonna be starting in about 10 seconds. Get yourself ready. Hit that number. Wall sits, let's go. I gotta get 21. You ready? Begin. Holy cow, keep working. Legs and arms. Woo! Hit that number. You got this. Just think. Rows and chest press is all we got left. 2 more minutes of work. Here we go, 20 seconds. We're moving on to that row. Here we go, I've got 21 reps I gotta do. 10 seconds. Get ready. Roll those shoulders down and back. Feet shoulder width apart. Bend at the knees. Hinge. Reach forward. Pull those elbows back using your shoulder blades. Exhale as you pull it up. Back stays flat. Keep those eyes toward your toes. Woo-hoo-hoo. Nice. 30 seconds of rest if you are there. 30 seconds, 20 seconds now of work left. Once you hit that row number, recover, prepare for our last move on the ground for this strength portion. 15 seconds. Let's go. You got this. Yep. Remember, we're doing that chest press. 5 seconds. Prepare. Shoulder blades are in the ground. Push those hips up to the sky. Chest press. Hit that number in your... Squeeze. Once you hit that number, you are done. You've got less than 25 seconds to go. You got this. Keep it up, keep it up, keep moving. Hit that number, whatever number you've got. 15 seconds, come on. I'm cheering you on, I'm right there with you. Work that chest, squeezing the glutes, squeezing the chest. Be done in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Rest. Awesome job. Woo! Nice little endurance piece. 7 minutes straight of work. Hitting those reps. You killed it. High five. We're not done yet. We're going to finish with a nice little core. I'm going to put the core moves up on the screen and we're just going to go through those a couple of times and call it a day. High five, everybody. You're doing awesome. Grab some water. Core is up on the screen. We're going through these. You got it, you got it. I'm gonna be there with you. We got 4 moves. Doing them twice through. We're gonna kind of go through them pretty quick. All right, so working that core. So first one, bicycle. We know this one. Bottom back, opposite elbow, opposite knee. I want you to keep that heel down, toes pointed up, nice, slow, and controlled movement. Butterfly sit up, put those heels together, and we're gonna come all the way up, or if you can only get those shoulder blades up off the ground, that works too, so maybe you're only here. That's fine. All right, and then we're doing a reverse crunch. Hands are underneath the hips. Tap those heels to the ground. Try to lift those hips up off the mat. And then we're gonna do pike, plank to pike. If this doesn't work for you, you can just hold a plank. I'll let you know when to switch, change. Or we're gonna be in a high plank here. You're gonna push it up into a nice little downward dog. And then here, okay? Here we go, we got this. 10 seconds, we're gonna get started. Let's go, let's go. All right, we're doing bicycles. Flat on the back, elbows are up, opposite arm or opposite elbow to opposite knee. Now you don't have to do these fast. The slower you do them, the more you gotta engage that core. Try to keep those shoulder blades up off the ground. Exhale as you twist, inhale as you find your breath. Good. Butterfly sit up, heels are together. You're either just coming up, shoulder blades up off the ground, or you're coming all the way up. It's up to you. Exhale as you come up, inhale as you come down. Or we're here. Just get those shoulder blades up off the ground. Good. Last 10 seconds, moving into that reverse crunch. You got it. Good. Nice. Place those hands underneath your booty. Try to reach those heels up to the sky, tap them to the ground. Good. If you want more, 6 inches and up. Good. Or you're just tapping those heels, lifting the booty. Last 5 seconds. Moving into either that plank or pike to plank. Good. Flip it over. High plank. And then push it up into pike. Into high plank. Good. A little shoulder work. Nice strong core, or you're just holding a plank. Good. Flip it back over. Bicycles. Last set of bicycles. I want you to see if you can go nice and slow. Ooh, holy burn. Good. Last 10 seconds. Feeling those obliques. 3, 2, 1. Butterfly sit-ups, heels are together. Either you're doing a nice little tiny crunch, reaching those hands up towards your knees, exhaling up, or you're coming all the way up. Good, really try to use your core, not momentum, to get you up. Last 5, you got it. Reverse crunches, let's go. Hands underneath the booty. Bring those feet up to the sky, tap those heels to the ground, working those lower abs for hardcore. 6 inches. 6 inches. Good. Those heels. Yep, use those abs. Last one of that plank to pike, or just hold plank. And let's go. Nice strong core. Hold for a couple of seconds in that high plank. Shoulders directly underneath over those wrists. Good. Nice strong back, strong glutes. Can you give me one more? 3, 2, 1. Ooh, nice. Push it back into child's pose. Sit back onto those heels, knees are wide. Reach those fingertips forward. Really nice stretch in those shoulder blades. Walk those hands to the right. Feel a nice stretch down that left side. Reach those hands forward again. And walk them to the left. Back in the middle. One more time in that cobra pose, so we're going into that tabletop and then dropping our fist down to the mat. Squeezing in the glutes, feel nice stretch in that lower back. Exhale into child's pose and then into tabletop. Push through those toes, we're going into that downward dog again. I want you to walk those feet, feel nice stretch down those calves. Push those hips to the sky. Bend at the knees, left foot comes outside that right hand, or that left hand, sorry. So you can either sit here in this nice long lunge or drop that back knee in the chest or sitting up all the way. Really a nice stretch of the hip flexor. Reach hands up to the sky if you want. Really push those hips forward, feeling a nice stretch in that front. Good, hands come back to the mat. Push into downward dog. Bend at the knees, right foot comes outside that right hand this time. You can either stay in this nice long lunge, lifting the chest, extending that back leg, or drop that back knee. Sit it nice and tall, squeezing this glute. Tuck those hips, feel a stretch here. Reach those hands up if you want. Reach them back behind. Nice. Hands back onto the mat, up into that downward dog one more time. Bend those knees, walk those hands to the feet. Nice little hamstring stretch. Maybe you can grab those toes. Knees don't have to be straight, so feel stretch on the back of your leg. As you inhale, slowly roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Big breath in up to the sky. Put those hands up. And exhale. If you need to grab onto a wall, go for it. Nice little quad stretch here. Well done. Super proud of you. Full body workout here. Nice little endurance piece. Switch legs. Find that balance. Pulling that heel up towards your glute, trying to keep that knee. Oops, in front of that quad. So good. Good. Energized. Strong. Hope you do too. Left foot coming down. Big arms open. Comes across. Super important to take care of yourself. even if it's just 30 minutes, step away from your busy day, move that body of yours, switch. That 150 minutes a week recommendation, chop it up, 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week. You just got yours for today. Good work. One more big breath in, up to the sky. Oh, breathe in peace and joy and grace and kindness, and breathe it out and spread it across the world with the people you are dealing with today. Be kind, be gracious. And choose joy. So thanks so much for joining me. I hope you join me back for another Keep Moving with Emily. Have a good day.